On Monday afternoon, we started by visiting the Swedish Bar Association, and we met the International Secretary Johan Sangborn. We were informed that an advocate in Sweden must be a member of this bar association or he's not allowed to use the title advocate. Advocates must follow certain ethical standards and have certain knowledges to be an advocate, and if they misuse their position, they will lose their title. Last meeting on Monday, we met the legal firm Sirio. It's one of the larger firms in Sweden. They have experience from around the globe, including India. And we met Carl Olof Boeng and others, and we had a cocktail invitation there. And we had small talks in small groups, and I learned a lot from them how they were working. And also one of the students after the tour has done his internship here at this company. On Tuesday morning, we went to the Stockholm Chamber of Commerce and we met Mr. Daniel Nutley, who is the international person working with the international relationships between the Chamber and the rest of the world. And he informed us about lots of advantages to be active in Stockholm, as it is a main center in the north of Europe and there are big companies in the field of IT and manufacturing and other areas, and that there are many positive reasons why a company should be active from Stockholm. After the Chamber of Commerce, we met a subsidiary to it, that is the Stockholm Arbitration Institute, who belongs to the Stockholm Chamber of Commerce. Our contact is Lise Alm, the head of business development, and we was informed about Arbitration Institute and how it works. And this institute is one of the world's most important because many years ago the Soviet Union and the United States of America decided that conflicts between the two parties should be solved at the Stockholm Arbitration Institute. On Tuesday afternoon, after we had our lunch at Meinheimer Swetling, we continued at the same place, who was having our seminar. It was started by three speeches from the Meinheimer Swetling company side. They are Sweden's biggest law firm, and it was their side was led by Mr. Andre Andersson, who is the global relationship partner in the company. They informed us about the company as such and the legal environment in Sweden and international work they do and so on. From our side, Delhi High Court Justice Sangrit Dingra Segal informed about arbitration in India. And Mr. Ober, that's myself, informed about cultural differences between India and Sweden. On Wednesday, our third day, we visited the Flemingsberg Legal Center, which has four units. First, we met the prosecutor, Karin Tekkonen, from the prosecutor's chamber, and learned about the prosecutor's work in Sweden, which partly is different from India, of course. Then we went to the court, where we met the judge, Karin Paul Bartes, who informed about and showed us the court. Interesting was also that people's views has been asked for, everyone who came there, and based on that they have made, from the survey, they have made some changes. For instance, on each quarter there was a map, and so if someone has never been in a court, they could show that map and explain where is the judge sitting, where is the defender sitting, where are the advocates, and where is the
prosecutor sitting and so on. The third place we visited was a jail. This is a jail used before and during the court trial. We met Sevim Aslansad, and we learned about a target to treat people well and young suspects to get support and education. Finally, we went to the police station. We met a policeman. He's an inspector, Per Lonkan Lundqvist. This police station covers a big area of the greater Stockholm, and it has also some substations. And we were informed about how they work, including sometimes coordinating the social services, etc.
We then went to Åland, so on Thursday we was on Åland. Åland is a group of many islands, mostly small islands, which is a part of the, and constitutes south western part of Finland, and it has a relatively small population, but they are still big in shipping and in some other areas. And we met Anders Ekström, the managing director of Chamber of Commerce and the business life organization in on these islands. We were informed about business life on Åland and that some companies are active in or towards India, including a company for some very special plastic material. They also showed us some local products that they recommended, and we saw them also and tested some eatables from that. On Thursday afternoon after lunch, we went to see the Åland's Lagtinget, which is a parliament valid for this group of islands. This group of islands is, as I said, a part of Finland, but has autonomy. We met Susanne Eriksson, who is working at Lagtinget, and they are now this Lagtinget, the parliament there, it makes the laws which are valid only for these islands within the framework of Finland, and they have several municipalities on the island, and some are small, and they are even so small some that they have only a bit over 100 inhabitants. And this is a very special background there, but these islands are still very, very successful business-wise and in other ways, and has become an important place for some business and tourism, and they are also a place that due to agreements with the European Union, that ships that stops at these islands will be able to sell without charging any tax. It's tax-free if they stop there. And this is an advantage for the islands. It means there's a lot of ships pass between Sweden and Finland and other places also stop at these islands, just even if it's only for 15 minutes.
master only has short courses. So, and there is in Denmark, I don't know the system, but you can ask when we come to the legal firm there. That is one of the questions I think is relevant to ask, and then we can learn, and then we can see, and we can see how does it work.
I would like to thank Mam and Sir, both of you, for such a good trip, and of course Mam and Sir for the yesterday talk we had about the European Union and all about the Europe and other countries, and especially about the Sweden and the and especially for the INBA. I never thought I would ever be coming to Sweden, but after coming here I regret like why I never come here back, and I never thought about it. So Sweden has even taught me how to be so active and punctual, and of course Sir has made me punctual, which I was never been. Like, you have to come at 11, 11 or 10 and 8 every time he says in a group day before, and I was see such messages and I'm like, oh really, in India back we are not so punctual, but yes, in Sweden you have to be, and even you misses a train, bus, everything.
And more appetite from Indian companies to invest here. There is a Danish-Indian Chamber of Commerce, fairly active, and it's about a month ago that they had a big investment seminar talking about Danish and Indian investments. We are in contact on an ongoing basis with some partners from the Indian law firm Dua Associates. They've been here a couple of times over the past few months. There is a Danish lawyer they have engaged. He works in England for an English law firm, but they've engaged him to sort of be the bridge between Denmark and India. And we are talking about joint seminars for certain business sectors that are of particular interest between Denmark and India, ICT, clean energy.
Yeah, of course. Now I'll get mine. Have some. Okay. So
the first,
okay, yeah, det er fint. I kan bare banke på det. Det er sådan lidt uformelt det her, så det kan bare komme lidt fint.
But I hope that you will find it interesting, and I'll give the floor to Matthias. As I mentioned, there will be some refreshments. I think it will be coffee and tea. It's perfectly fine to drink. All of it. It's and there might even be tap water, which I know is in an Indian context can be a bit delicate, but in Denmark it's very clean, very safe.
I would be focusing on the implementations of the principles, environmental law principles in India. I just have a pool of 5 or 6 pictures, and each picture has a story. So I'd be linking that and would be explaining the scenario in India. Like, I'll just start off.
Perfect.
And I just undertook a project which was related to what emissions can be saved in such synergies created.
As well as to protect the environment. So he is the best enemy and as well as the best friend of the environment. So let's start.
Good afternoon everyone, here is Gurpreet Kaur. And as my friend had discussed about the situation of India and all of another friends, what is going on in India environmentally and the legal position. I would like to add some more points of that. Yes, we are agreeing that the we are facing some problems relating to environment because the people are there not compromising with their facilities. And but they don't want to accept that thing. If they want to protect their environment, they have to compromise somewhere. And for that, our government is also doing a lot of things, like there are also tribunals.
Good afternoon, respected sir, ma'am, and delegates. I'm Stramona Mitra, and I'm here on behalf of Indian National Bar Association to deliver a presentation on environmental laws and regulations in India. I'll start off with a brief overview, which includes the definition, followed by a few, this is the mini constitution, 42nd Amendment Act, which deals with environmental laws, followed by fundamental rights, duties, the most important acts that are there in the within the legal regimen of environment, and lastly violations and the arena of public interest litigation.
Greeting for the day, everyone. I would like to thank you all that you have given us your prestige time for giving explaining us about the environment. Firstly, I would like to deal with the environment laws and regulation in India. What is like environment laws and regulation? We have different types of acts, different types of laws, different types of regulation which help for the efficient and sustainable development of the environment in our country. Greetings for the day, sir and ma'am. Thank you so much, sir and ma'am, for making this trip a memorable trip. And thank you, Puneet sir, for organizing such a great trip. I'm going back with a bag full of knowledge. I'll try to implement this knowledge in others, and hoping forward for the trip of INBA that we can join this thing again, as it's a very knowledgeable trip. Thank you, ma'am and sir. Thank you so much. Bye!
Sweet Kumar, and I'm chairperson of Indian National Bar Association Student Section. And I would firstly like to thank Kaviraj sir, the Secretary General of Indian National Bar Association, to provide such an amazing opportunity to visit Europe and have such amazing meetings. And I would like to thank Ubod sir and Meenakshi ma'am for such a beautiful arrangements. And stop wishing, start doing.
So I would like to recommend to all law students that stop wishing and
start doing.
Thank you. Bye bye.
So stop wishing and start doing, because that's what INBA is for. Thank you.
Start doing and stop wishing. Start doing and stop wishing.
I'm very happy to be a part of INBA and this Europe too. And I would like to thank you, Puneet sir, Ubod sir, ma'am, and all the team and all the friends. They make me feel very happy. So I would like to see you all that you should also join this group. So stop wishing and start doing. Thank you.